So, and then also premiering this week, we have the Emoji Movie.
Okay, oh. So now I have a personal connection to this movie. So I'm in my, because my friend wrote it.
Oh, okay.
So in my heart of hearts, I want it to be, and we know some people who are doing voices in it.
Sure.
I want it to be a huge success. So I feel like, unlike the Trump administration, I'm going to recuse myself from this discussion because I'm sure. So I want it to be successful because I want my friend
to do well,
and I want it to just be a big honking success for him.
This goes back to our discussion before. My kids want to see this movie.
So, same with mine.
So here's the thing. Whether you and I want to see it or we're going to enjoy it or not, we're going to be paying for it.
T.J. Miller is going to do a few things that will make you laugh.
Yes.
I guarantee there'll be things that do it.
Right.
And to me, I have to.
So there's four tickets coming regardless.
Same with me. And I'm going to support him because I love Eric Segal. But I mean,
especially the way our kids are on their devices so much is like the Emoji Movie. It's one of those movies that was created in a marketing department that will just make money.
I hope it does. I really do. And, you know, whatever. It's like, also you want, also the experience of going to the movie with your family and doing that.
Right.
Like, my kids have been watching So You Think You Can Dance. Is that a show that I would be like, I gotta see that.
Right.
Honey, I
gotta see if they
wake
can
up,
dance.
Wake up. We gotta come down and binge. What? No, I would never see that. But we all sat around together and we were kind of experiencing it. And like,
we're doing that with American Grit. That's the John Cena show where it's basically Survivor.
Yes, yes, I've seen promos for that.
But way to prepare your family for the apocalypse.
There's some really good lessons in there. You know,
so I mean, I learned
a train to fall into a lake.
So my attitude is like, okay, I'm gonna spin it in a way of like, all right, if you go out with your family,
right,
hopefully people will see this with their kids and have a good time. But it is definitely not a movie that I'm saying like I'm itching to see this movie or see what it's gonna be. I just hope it does well for my friends.
Yeah, you know, you have parent reaction, same as me.
Yeah.
So next movie, Atomic Blonde. I'm excited for this
movie. On a graphic novel.
It's based on a graphic
novel. I like Charlize Theron as a badass.
Yeah.
I love, first of all, the trailer's pretty dope.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Just the refrigerator ass kicking scene makes me wanna like, I'm like, God, that's,
and we need more
work like
good
that since William Perry.
Not since William Perry
dove in the end zone.
We need more good action movies. Fast and the Furious we have, but they're tongue in cheek. Like we like more Mad Max, like more like a movie like this. I'm excited to see.
I love this movie too, and I guess like the most difficult part is it's almost like trying to make stand up work in a movie is with a female heroine is like, okay, if Ronda Rousey went into the UFC ring with John Bones Jones, he would kill her. He would literally kill her. Mm-hmm. He would hit her twice with his elbows in her head and she would not wake up. She would be dead. So how do you take a female lead and be like, I believe all the fighting, and she's not a superhero. Mm-hmm. I mean, is she a superhero in this?
No.
So
no.
Like, she's not like a trained assassin spy, right? Mm-hmm. So she's not a superhero. How do you make all of that believable? That like she goes in and kicks everybody's ass and you're like, well,
and it's like set in the 80s too.
Right. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. There's a lot in there that I think is really cool. And I think I feel like they've figured a few things out in this. And I love Charlize Theron. And you want to go back to the Mad Max movie.
Yeah.
She fucking captivated me that whole movie.
That was her film.
She was awesome.
Because she was the one who, you know, Thomas Hardy had six lines and no emotion.
Right.
You know what I mean? He was just kind of driving the truck forward, literally and figuratively. She was the one who
grounded the movie.
That's right. Amidst all that, had the emotion that pulled you in. So no matter what she does, and by the way, one of my favorite movies she ever did was with our buddy Patton Oswalt, Young Adult.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. She was amazing in that movie. She was incredible. So I feel like she will take this character and give it some levels and depth in a way that maybe someone else who's just kind of like an action-y person, in a way that a Ronda Rousey couldn't.
Right.
Because she's like a really good actress as well. So I'm excited to see this. Whether I see this in the theater or whether I see it when it comes out, I am definitely going to see this
movie. I'll see
this. I'm excited to see it. And the next one, An Inconvenient Sequel, Truth to Power. This is Al Gore's sequel to An Inconvenient Truth.
More hippie bullshit, guys.
Yeah.
climate change isn't happening. It's a lie from the liberal media.
So, if you want to see what the liberal media looks like in movie form, check it out.
I really do want to see this because I want to know what the hell is going on. But I am looking forward to, and I don't know if you guys heard this, but a prequel coming out, The Convenient Truth.
Yes.
That's going to come and kind of back everything into. This is when we all thought the environment was going to be fine.
It's like Planet of the Apes.
Polar bears have enough food.
Yeah.
The ice caps are too big.
You know what I find fascinating about, like,
more
if you watch
hairspray.
This, if you watch this trailer, you realize that there's some very recent footage of Trump. And so you know after Trump got elected,
that
there
were
was
like,
some recutting, like, well, well we can't release this movie.
That's the beauty of documentaries. And anytime right. I'm watching a documentary,
well, they did that with 13th.
Yeah. Yeah, mm-hmm. There was a lot of last-minute editing going
on. Also, I mean, literally...
Just you have the slots open. It's just get it, cut it, digitize it, slap that shit in. People don't care if your documentary footage, especially footage of real events, isn't the most high quality.
Right. Right. Okay. It can all be grainy.
Your transitions. Like if I'm watching a documentary and there's an out of focus shot, my brain goes to the point of, oh shit, that is real. Well, what is happening right now? The cameraman can't get too quick enough, or woman
right.
can't get too quick enough. Mm-hmm. So like,
or the cameraman's stupid.
Right. Or he's just lazy and checking his phone.
Ineffective.
Yeah. No, but I mean, like. No, but my point is that, like, those moments are so real that they have to put it in there the way it is. And there's, like, a dirtiness to that that I think all documentary film fans kind of love. Because you caught a real moment.
You're
right
more forgiving
there.
Yes. In that. The other thing that I'm curious about this movie, too, that I want to see, it looks like there's also some like, because there have been some amazing technological advances in terms of stuff. And he's showing some of that, like, look, it's bad. It's getting bad. It's getting worse. But... Because that's part of the problem.
Here's the science behind the solution.
Here's some great solutions that we need to get behind.
Although it is, the world is crazy, and I think you could keep making these movies. The idea of self-driving cars, the idea of, because I just heard a whole report about like people on bikes, and how like their incidence of accidents with self-driving cars is way less with people on bikes, and so it just, because they're not angry because the
sensors
the sensors, they understand, and you know it's almost like the same technology that are selling in cars right now, where if you're not paying attention and there's something coming up, your car will automatically brake for you. It kind of, that's literally that expanded out into like driving, but they don't drive angry like humans do. And
well,
so,
you know, I've also like on my YouTube show, Political Vigilante, I found some articles, like one of them, this new technology, they found, they've developed solar panels that can take moisture from the air and create drinkable water. So you can just have, clean water source, like you could be living out in the middle of the desert and have clean water.
I mean, I want solar panels on my house so bad. I don't understand. I don't understand why huge swaths of the desert of our country, I mean, huge swaths of it,
just
aren't
solar
just
panels.
Lined with solar panels, because nobody gives a shit what it looks like. You could power the entire western half of the country.
That drive to Vegas could power Vegas.
Could power Vegas, but you could literally power the entire western part of the country. Like, do you know that because of all the solar panels in California,
We've had excess.
Excess, and we have to pay for it to go to like Arizona and some other places as well. So
we have to pay for it to leave?
To give it to somebody else. So I feel like...
Well, also, too, like whenever
it serves us right.
That's why this movie, I feel like, is so important, because of all these things that are on the tip of our tongue that we're talking about, and why people just need to see this. And the problem is the wrong people aren't seeing it.
I would recommend.
Well, the companies are very skilled. They have spent hundreds of millions of dollars to let people know, maybe climate change isn't
happening.
It may not be real.
Or we're coming up with a cleaner gas.
This is like one of those things that's almost impossible is, can you go see a movie like this with an open mind? Can you just say...
On a first date.
Oh, yeah. Could I see a documentary like this
with
an open mind?
Can you have sex in a theater
Could I
be undecided about jerking off in the movie theater? Could I be undecided?
Oh, wind turbines.
Like, look, I'm not doing this, honey. The sun is doing it.
Now I have to sell it back to Arizona.
Oh, shit! No!
I think you can go and do it with an open mind.
Yeah, I think
and
you
that's
can.
A good way.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, cool movies to watch, you guys. Randy's.
Hot shot first! Kitten heads across the